Now we are going to talk about the acceleration has direction and magnitude. That means acceleration is a vectorial quantity, like a velocity. What we discussed while we are talking about the difference between velocity and speed, velocity has direction and magnitude, and the speed has got only magnitude. So acceleration very similar as the velocity, which has direction and the magnitude. And just imagine, if we have a railway, on the railway we have a train. And the train, at that point, it is not moving now, let's say. Initial velocity of the train is zero. When it starts moving, generally, trains are following almost straight line. We can say straight path, straight railway, we can say. Not always, but most of the times they are trying to construct their way straight. So this will be good example for us now. So when it starts moving in the right direction, that means positive direction, we can say also, the velocity of the train can start increasing. And as you know, the trains speeding up, that means their velocity increase, then the some part of the path, they are moving with the constant velocity. So let's say it goes, and the velocity becomes constant. Let's say here, and it moves with the constant velocity. After a while, before the station, it starts slowing down. Then, finally, it stops. Finally, it stops. So here, the velocity increase. Here, we have a constant velocity. And here, velocity decrease. And what is the mean of constant velocity? What's the velocity decrease? What's the velocity increase? We will discuss about that on this graph. If we look at the graph, we have a 3 point: point A, point B, and the point C. At the point A, as you see, this is the graph of the velocity and the time. At the point A, as you see, the velocity start increasing. Increasing and increasing. So here, we have a change in velocity, but that velocity increasing. That means we have an acceleration. So that acceleration is the positive acceleration, we can say. So acceleration at this part is positive. And for the point B, as you see, we have a straight line on the graph. We have a straight line on the graph. This is the velocity graph. It means we have a constant velocity if we have a straight line. If we have a constant velocity, what does it mean? It means there is not any change in velocity. If there is no change in velocity, in this case, acceleration becomes zero. Just imagine that you are driving with the constant velocity. So if there is no any change in it, so that means there is no any change in velocity, means acceleration is zero. Because acceleration is change in velocity. If there is no change, no acceleration. At the third part, at the point C, as you see, the velocity graph starts decreasing. This line starts decreasing. So there is a change in velocity, but the change is decreasing. If we go to other picture, which we discuss about the acceleration, if you look at the first picture, here we discuss about the increasing in velocity. So, as I said, the acceleration is positive. And at the second picture, we discuss about the decrease in velocity, 20, 18, 16, and 14. So, as I said, the acceleration is negative. And I name it, actually scientists were name it deceleration, we can say. And let's go to other page again. So here we have a decrease in the velocity. If we have a decrease in the velocity, that means acceleration in this case negative. Now we are going to discuss about the relation between velocity and the acceleration, and the sign of the velocity and the sign of the acceleration. Here it is important. On this chart, I'm going to explain it. And I gave you example about the train, as you remember. And train is starting its motion with the zero velocity, then it starts increasing its velocity. Its velocity increase, it means. And after a while, the train moves with the constant velocity. After a while, train gonna slowing down. Slowing down. So in this part, we have a positive acceleration. In this part, we have a zero acceleration. In this part, we have a negative acceleration. So here, we have to talk about some unique points. And if our initial velocity and the acceleration positive, it means the object is speeding up. If the initial velocity is negative and the acceleration is negative, it means again object is speeding up. What does the mean of the positive velocity? If we take the x and y axis, this is the positive x direction, this is the negative x direction. So now we are talking about the motion of the train. So if the train moving in this direction, it means it's moving in the positive direction. So if we have a velocity, that velocity is the positive. If we have acceleration, that acceleration is positive. So in this case, the object is speeding up. If the train moving in opposite direction, which means direction of the negative, so if we have a negative acceleration, in this case, it's again speeding up. So here, for you, there is a keynote. If the velocity and the acceleration carrying same sign, the object is speeding up. But if the acceleration and the velocity carrying opposite signs, the object is slowing down. You have to keep this one in your mind. The next year, it can be useful. So this is important. If the acceleration and velocity has same sign, it is speeding up. If the acceleration and velocity has opposite sign, that means that object is slowing down. And here, if the velocity is different than the zero, in this case we have a zero acceleration, it means zero acceleration means there is no change in velocity. If there is no change in velocity, that gives us information about constant velocity. If there is no change in velocity, that means that object moving with the constant velocity, we can say. And if the initial velocity is zero and the acceleration positive or negative, it gives us information the object is speeding up from the rest because its initial velocity is zero. And another case, initial velocity zero and the acceleration zero. So the object velocity is zero and its acceleration is zero. That means there is no any change in its velocity. So in this case, that object remaining at rest. That means that object is not moving. Now we are going to talk about motion with constant acceleration. And what does it mean, motion with constant acceleration? If you ask yourself, what you are going to answer me? Does it mean constant velocity? Does it mean constant speed? None of that. Now, we have a constant acceleration, it says. What is the acceleration? Change in velocity. So, if we have a constant acceleration, that means the velocity changing constantly. What does it mean? If you have an object, car, let's say it is a car, its initial velocity 5 meters per second. And if your acceleration is 3 meters per second squared, so after 1 second, it will be 8 meters per second, its velocity. After 1 second, it will be 11. After 1 second, it will be 14. After 1 second, 17. After 1 second, 20 meters per second will be its velocity. So, if we have a constant acceleration, the object is speeding up with the constant acceleration. So, because of that, at every second, velocity of the object increase with the same ratio, with the same amount, which is 3. I just give any number from my mind. So constant acceleration means never, it doesn't mean never constant velocity, okay? This is important. It doesn't mean constant velocity. It doesn't mean, okay? Keep this one in your mind. Constant acceleration means that there is change in velocity, but that change happen constantly. This is very important. I'm gonna explain this with simulation. I hope you are going to enjoy it. Hi guys, now we will talk about the constant acceleration. I will apply the force to this cabinet and it will start moving with the constant acceleration, and we will see what does the constant acceleration mean. Does the constant acceleration mean to us constant velocity? Let's see it. I apply the force, constant force. As you see, now acceleration is at the constant rate, but the velocity at every second increasing and increasing. So constant acceleration means, let's pause it, constant acceleration does not mean to us constant velocity. If we check it from here, from the second, as you see, acceleration here 1.4, acceleration at every second, if you look at this value, acceleration at every second, as you see, 1.4. But if you look at the velocity chart, velocity graph, at every second, the velocity velocity keep increasing. So according to this, if we have a constant acceleration means, it must mean to us there is a change in velocity, but that change has a constant rate, constant amount. For example, from 6 to 8, we have 2 seconds, and it's increased from 6.1 to 8.9, after 2 seconds, it will be 11.6. So there is 11.7. I cannot hold it exactly on right position. So here we have a constant rate of increasing velocity with the constant acceleration. However, if the acceleration 0, there is no change in velocity. It means we have a constant velocity. Now, in this part, I'm gonna give you 4 different formulas about the constant acceleration or it has another name, uniform acceleration. Now, we have a first formula, that formula about the displacement, displacement with uniform acceleration. This is the first formula. Delta x is the displacement equal half in the parentheses v initial plus v final multiplied by the t. And v initial means initial velocity, v final means final velocity. So delta x is displacement. V initial means initial velocity. V final means final velocity. Delta t is time for us. So for every formula, we will have some questions according to formula where you can solve these questions. And the first one in front of us, it is the sample problem 1C. A racing car reaches a speed of 42 meter per second. The racing car reached 42 meter per second. Then it begin a uniform negative acceleration. So in the question it says uniform negative acceleration. So in these types of question, you have to see what? You have to see uniform acceleration sentence. When you see the uniform acceleration sentence, you have to understand this is all about a constant acceleration. Using its parachute and the braking system, and comes to rest. So it has velocity 42 meter per second. We have uniform negative acceleration. Then it comes to rest 5.5 seconds later. Find how far the car moves while stopping. And now, first of all, let's write the givens. It says racing car reached 42 meter per second. Then it begins. So 42 meter per second is our initial velocity. It is 42 meter per second. And it says it comes to rest. It means to us finally the racing car stop. So V final will be zero, we can say. And there is information about time. So delta t is equal 5.5 seconds. And the question says find how far. How far means it is the displacement. So this question says calculate the displacement. So it's saying what is the delta x. This formula all about this question. Delta x equal half v initial plus v final multiplied by the time. But in which case we can use this formula? If the question says uniform acceleration, that is very important. So I will substitute the givens. Half is the coefficient and v initial is the 42 plus v final is the 0 multiplied by what is the time? 5.5. So that will be equal what? 2 and 42 cancel each other, 21 times 5.5. So delta x is gonna be 115.5 meters. So this is our answer of the question. Now we reach the practice 1C is about this formula, the first formula about the uniform acceleration. So I will, there are four formulas. I will solve some of them to support you. I hope so. You are gonna understand solutions. Hello, welcome everyone. In this question it says a car accelerates uniformly from rest. This is the important word. speed of 23.7 km per hour in 6.5 seconds. What is the distance covered by the car? And it's asking distance, and for formula of distance due to this question, half x equals half v initial plus v final multiplied by the time. And I will write the givens. What is the initial velocity? Initial velocity it's zero because it says from rest. Okay. And the time is given 6.5 seconds. Then final velocity we finally equal 23.7 kilometers per hour. And it is kilometer, it's given kilometer per hour. I have to convert it into meter per second because the unit of the time is second. So to convert it from kilometer per hour to meter per second, 23.7, I will convert kilometer into meter, that means 1000 meter over 1 hour equal 3600 second. So we finally gonna be 6.58 meter per second. Next step, I will substitute them in the formula. X equal half v initial plus v final times t. Half times v initial, initial velocity is the zero, plus final velocity is the 6.58 meter per second, multiply by the time, and the time is given in this question 6.5. So final x gonna be 21.385 meters. Thanks for listening. In this question it says a driver in a car traveling speed of 78 km per hour sees a cat 101 meter away on the road. How long will it take for the car to accelerate uniformly? And it says again, accelerate uniformly, stop in exactly 99 meter. So that means the car must stop in the 99 meter. So this is x. And it says uniformly accelerate and stop. So if it says stop, finally, so we final, that means final velocity gonna be zero. And the x must be 99 meters and initial velocity is 78 kilometer per hour to kilometer per hour to meter per second. I have to convert this because the unit of the x is given meter, or I can convert meter into kilometer, but I prefer in this question convert kilometer per hour into meter per second. 78 times 1000 meter over 3600 second. So we initial gonna be 21.66 meter per seconds. And I will substitute given in the formula, and the question is in this question how long. How long means it's asking what is the time. So x equals half v initial plus v final multiplied by the time. So it's asking time, and x given 99 equal half v initial is given 21.66 plus v final gonna be zero multiplied by the time, and then 99 equal 21.66 over 2 gonna be 10.83 t. So if you divide by both sides, 10.83, we're gonna find t, and the t will be 99 over 10.83. That means that's equal 9.83 14 seconds. Thanks for listening.